Film has a language which is defying the vernaculars that we both of us speak.
Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
My name is M. Padmakumar. I am the director of Mamangam Movie, which is going to be released on December 12th.
I'm Shankar Ramakrishnan. I have worked along with Papetan to be a part of Mamangam. It's releasing on December 12th, so I think it's hitting theatres in all over India and coming out in primarily Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu and Hindi versions. You're watching this on IndianExpress.com. Is one of the rarest opportunities that normally a regional language film gets to get released in a wider audience kind of a setup. So it doesn't happen every day. These kind of films doesn't get produced every day, and it requires a lot of human effort and also a focus to one's own vision about filmmaking, what it kind of should be. And to work with Mamuka, who's kind of a father figure to most of the young directors and also filmmakers, it's kind of an opportunity which presents you with a very rare situation that we have the resources to make it. To make a small film itself is a very difficult process. To create a large canvas, and he was very understanding in kind of getting the screenplay done to fit the mold of the film. So it is like working with people who you are comfortable, and also you have a big passion towards making such kind of films reach a larger audience.
This Malayalam industry is very small, our marketing is very small market. And we cannot get such a producer. That's the main thing. The kind of cinema films, the big budget movie, we cannot get such a producer. It belongs to me. It's a lifetime, once in a life it is happening, this kind of movies. Usually we are doing social movies. It is the regular background, regular characters. And we have to do something special, different.
When you go outside Kerala, the geographical borders, people see maybe a particular brand of Malayalam movies which used to be B movies or at some point of time, or very artistically acclaimed kind of movies made by some very renowned international filmmaker. So now when you have a movie like Magadira or Bahubali, we don't actually culturally resound with that kind of a film. This is more about an internal characterization, internal drama, and the scale is actually within. So to bring that kind of a sensibility, we have to understand that the story which is being narrated, while it was made, the larger sense of Kerala was not there, or even the language of Malayalam was not really formed at that point of time. So we are talking about a pan-Dravidian state, which, you know, like where a culture, where a melange of different kind of people came from different parts of the world to participate in a particular event. And there are two clans. When you see a film like Apocalypto, or when you see a film like Aguirre the Rat of God, or so these kind of films actually defy the language barrier and becomes the language of film. At that point of time, we had taken some cinematic liberties, you know, like a lot of drama perspective. We are not following any one particular character as true to his history, because it is also our version of how things would have happened. And I think it is natural to bring out the story element and also the film moments within it, rather than sticking on to a particular, because that is also history, because it's depending on who tells history. History, palapuram parayna alkarada point of view.
And this is actually, history is there, but we have included some myth characters also, we have included in the film. Not pure history. History is there.
More than that, the canvas is, the backdrop is historical, and also the characters are fictional. Bahubali is a film done as a fantasy, you know, like it's like more of a fantasy that happens in a fictitious world. But Mamangam basically is a tale which runs in the nerve of every Malayali. You know, like everyone knows what Mamangam is about. It is not a, nobody has heard about Mahishmadi before, but everybody has heard of Mamangam, and a lot of tales have been told about Mamangam before also. So coming from a filmmaking background which is more realistic and more true to the, you know, the core vision of it, I think it is completely in the other dimension of Bahubali.